great to see you.
Better to see you.
Nice to meet you.
Welcome home.
Thank you very much.
How are you?
I'm great. A little jet lag, but good.
I bet you are, because you've been, I mean, you've been flying around everywhere, Hawaii to here to Washington to here. And here's a picture of you that you tweeted from right before the White House Correspondents' Dinner, where you were asking, should you wear a bow tie or a standard necktie?
Yes.
And I was desperate to tell you to wear the standard necktie.
I'm so glad you did, because that's what I went with. You know, the president is debating on whether to kill terrorists, mm-hmm. and I'm trying to figure out whether to wear a straight tie or a bow tie. These are the tough
questions. Were you happy with the choice? The crowdsourcing worked out?
You know what the real reason I did it was because last year I was lucky enough to go to the same dinner and I wore a bow tie.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't want the fashionistas to be like, he's wearing the same thing 2 years
in a row. No, that actually makes sense. But can you tie a bow tie?
I actually can.
Oh,
yeah.
My, because it's a gift, I think. I think it's a real skill. Because I am not very good at tying a bow tie. I tried to learn online to tie Mark's bow tie. It was a total disaster.
I have trouble.
No, I tie a bow tie maybe once every 10 years, but that was my 10-year time.
And then you were also last night at a dinner for the Prime Minister of Japan where you pretended to be Hillary Clinton.
Right. I think I fooled a lot of people.
Yeah, that's another... I love following you on Twitter. These are great.
I like following you, too.
Thank you very much. How was that dinner?
It was fantastic, actually. I'm always fascinated by, you know, how politicians can actually be... They can have a public face and be at a state dinner and kind of give a great speech and be present in that moment. And at the same time, like, there's a Chinese dissident that is, you know, seeking refuge in the U.S. Embassy. And the Secretary of State literally left that dinner to fly to China.
Right.
And it's a pretty fascinating study in human nature, the way that they can juggle those things.
It's so true.
Yeah.
You've had so much going on, and your son is a championship tennis player. You had to leave him behind in Hawaii.
Championship might be a bit of an exaggeration. He's a tennis player, and he plays for a very good team in Hawaii, and he's got his state championships this weekend. And I'm one of the saddest things about being here in New York.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Is that you're gonna miss it?
Yeah, I'm gonna miss it. And you know, there are these moments in a father-son relationship, mm-hmm. that are really important. You know.
Yeah.
And you know, like the first date is really important.
Right.
And I feel like, you know, when he's got a big athletic event, you know, I should really be there.
Well, there'll be other big athletic events, and what you're doing is important. And by the way, your kids are spectacular.
I think
you should know that. You know, he's got two boys, and they're spectacular. We're gonna come. We have to take a commercial break, but I love crossover stories because we used to do it in the soap opera world all the time.
Right.
So you're crossing over with NCIS, right?
Absolutely.
And we're gonna talk about the crossover between Hawaii Five-0 and NCIS when we return. We're back with Daniel Dae Kim, star of Hawaii Five-0, doing an NCIS LA crossover, which started last night and finishes tonight.
That's right.
So tell me about the episode.
Well, it starts in Hawaii, where we have a bad guy who has decided to weaponize smallpox. Yeah, so it's
my worst fear.
It's a laugh a minute.
Yeah.
the bad guy happens to have a connection to one of the NCIS LA characters, and so they come over and help us solve the crime.
It's actually very topical, because I don't know if you were following that news story recently where the woman, it's not to weaponize, but they thought there was a woman on an airplane with a contagious disease. They thought she had monkeypox.
Right.
Turns out she just was suffering from bug bites, but the entire airplane was quarantined and the people were like trapped on the plane for a long time.
I read about that. Wasn't it bed bugs or something like that?
Yeah, something like that. Some other irritant, but yeah. not worthy of a quarantine.
Yeah,
yeah.
Right.
Let's take a look at how this plays out on the show. It's a clip where you're on your way now to L.A. in search of the criminal.
Let's watch.
Los Angeles, where the crazy come to vacation.
I kind of like it. It's like being at the circus.
You may not want to be down here during the full moon, though.
Now maybe we missed him.
Maybe not.
Is that him?
I'd call that a yes.
Two of you running. I'm sure I understand that. Run, GDK,
right?
He's so good.
I was just trying to keep up with LL Cool J, man.
I mean, is he still growing? He looks like he's getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
I feel like a 12-year-old standing next to him, I swear.
Yeah, when I was watching last night, the fun thing about Hawaii Five-O is just that iconic theme song when
it's
the show
so
starts.
Great.
You know you're into it. You're set for the hour.
Absolutely.
Well, it is Hawaii Five-O Mondays at 10 p.m. on CBS. So great to see you always. Daniel Dae Kim, everybody. When we return, we're going to look at perfect sunglasses for every face. Don't go away.